A good afternoon and a very warm welcome to the Tops International Arena for the Global Champions League presented by Stal Tops on a Sunday. Unique occasion, it is also a unique season, but we are very happy to bring you this Global Champions League right here from Tops International Arena. Jean Satran, the Monaco Aces, 16 to go. DJ Sport, Satisfaction.
Yeah, this is a great man. Yeah, she's on a roll.
Jumped a great Grand Prix yesterday.
Yeah, training with Julianne Eppillard and great team they've got going there together, and she's got some really nice horses. Fanon was amazing. We also sold that one a year ago, and she's had a lot of success with that one. And she's really in good shape, and she's young, and she's keen, and she's motivated, and yeah, it's going very well for her.
Well, come and on, this is together. For a clear.
Very good. Great. Wow. It's tough to keep it at a time. Well. Yeah. Super. Got a fast rider with her.
This would, excellent. Yeah, because we only have one double clear so far. We had Lions.
Spring chicken. As we say.
They take top position, and if they would stay in top position, they lost to go in the second round. That's why this time is now so important.
Yeah. Oh,
ah, good one. Look at
easy
that.
Easy peasy.
That is 7 seconds faster.
Which worked very well for him. Big striding horse. The nine, beautifully. And that. Making it look pretty easy.
Some jockey, yeah?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Daniel's tall, but he's really with the horse, huh?
All well for Deucer and for the Pirates. Jade, a mare that did very well last year on the tour.
Yeah, he's done a lot of good things with his horse. Yeah, she's only 11. She's got a huge stride as well. Yep. You can see how short the 6 was for him. Oh, bit deep, but it's okay. So you just risk a little bit of that for the 8 there.
You want to get a sort of a steep landing.
Yeah.
You find yourself find
yeah,
more
it's difficult because
yeah.
If you don't do enough, you're going to have the back pole. But yeah, you got to try to not override the oxer too much.
Yeah.
So that you can get the 8 a little bit easier.
You did
and
less.
It's not just a matter about getting the 8, it's how you get the 8. You know, with the momentum. And so he's, you know, he's trying to jump the clear rounds, obviously, but without going too fast.
135, 31 to beat. But they won't make the time of Monaco Aces. Last fence.
Yeah.
That was 7 strides in there. I think he did into the.
Did he?
Yeah.
Well, he got it good. He's a big striding horse.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's just all about how you get there. It's not overly fast.
Tremendous scope.
Yeah. Oh, short in there. 5, 6, 8 strides, because otherwise the 6 is going to get too short. Holding a beautiful rounder.
Michael on Beauville.
Yeah, he's just an incredible rider. Oh. He's in such good form. He's always in form.
Yeah, very unlucky yesterday with
Oh, I know.
What a pity of a fault in the Grand
but,
Prix.
So much talent, and he wins on everything.
And it's never spectacular. It's never flashy. It's never. Yeah. Extreme is just very.
Yeah, you don't need to be spectacular. You know, the horses just have to know where the poles are and be with you, eh? Oh, no, how is he? Time is good.
Not
wow.
As the aces, but.
Family team.
You've got. it's all up to you at that point.
Yeah. But if Monica Oasis ends up last, they'll be fine with that. It's a great ring to ride in. But
so a lot of people work in the triple combination. He just let it happen.
He's very good at letting the horses jump. He's a very, very good calculated rider. He was very good yesterday. Oh, did you see that?
Yep.
He threw the reins and gave a bit of leg, but then he got it back.
Ryan and Simon de Lestre to follow. And that is a very fast combination, so could just be challenging Monaco Aces here.
This is an amazing horse. It's won a lot of... He will definitely do the 8, but it's probably going to ride normal for him. Unless he does 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. See, he just got a balancing 8 there. This horse is smart. He knows exactly where the poles are. He knows... different kind of a...
Yep.
He had a bit more blood. Whoa.
For first place and...
Smart.
Double of verticals, always short. Blank, always room.
Yes.
Always. Just simply.
Yeah. You don't want to get close to those blanks.
No.
Yeah, they're a different shape of a fence and they sit differently in the cups and, you know, they're delicate. You know, they don't need to be touched hard to fall down.
London Knights are the last team in round one. It is Stalando and Martin Fuchs, later on Hurricane and Olivier Philippard.
Lucky last.
Yeah. New composition in terms of horses. Same riders that dominated the championship 2019 and 18, of course. No explosion. He is still on the American continent. But, quite a long time. Paul Schokkemoel read it. Well, no need for Ben Meyer, because it's clear from Martin Fuchs.
Yeah, the 7, I thought he might do that.
For me, it looked like he went for the 7 fairly late. Only after 3 strides he started reducing.
He did that on purpose, so he could slow down at the end to give the horse time. He didn't want to get there. Having to push them.
Too early.
So he made sure he could slow down at the end. He's a huge stride horse. Holding 7, you see that? Whoa.
Really short here for him.
Yeah. So he got him back good that he can come again.
Very strong
very
ride
round.
Actually. Yeah.
Yeah.
The first round has been held just this afternoon, and that first round has created the start list for the second round of Global Champions League presented by Stal Dops. 16 teams, 2 riders per team in perfect conditions. So a horse change for Derek Kenny. Would that be Belo Horizonte that is riding here? I believe so. By Balou Bendrouet and Clearway. He's very forward in the combination. Deep to the oxen. Ooh, and now he has to ride out. And he even has to ride for the 7. Tells you a little bit about the stride as well on Chris Gelding. But it is a very positive and very forward clear. And after Paris Panthers, there's a whole group of teams that come on a score of 4. So Harry can put the pressure on those to come. Not super edgy that turn, but beautifully balanced. Didn't waste any meters. Ooh, looked like Cass jumped a little bit to the right, and then Harry had to recover, re-steer, rebalance in the approach to Global Champions. Stay a little bit more to the outside to find room enough. There's 1, 2 extra stride for 7 for double clear. And it is double clear in round 2 that makes it 8 all over for Paris Panthers. Six in here. In or out? Oof. Tries to steer inside, gets the inside turn. That's a second to make the inside turn. Now we saw it from Kenny and Smallers as well. And Now into the triple. Is she too much forward? No, it looks like she's managing really well. Lets her slow down even in the triple combination. And the seven are there as well. And H&M Indiana and Mali Bajo Johnson jump another clear. This was a plank they had down. And she jumps it really well now. The mare by Diamant de Sumilly. Ooh, that's a strong touch. But the pole is still up and the Eagles are still on four. And have a chance to overtake Paris Panthers. It's equally an inside turn. We'll see that from a lot of pairs now. As the margins are getting smaller and smaller. Beautiful shape through the triple. And the easy seven for Weishaupt sets her up. Gives her a lot of push and gets a clear in round two. And the Berlin Eagles lead after four teams. Because all of these carry a score of four. Valkenswaard United and Funky Fred with Marcus Eining. And that's what you'd expect. The riders to jump that tailored fence on the right, left on your screen. We've seen a lot jump that on the left, right on your screen, and drift a little bit and lose meters. Nice collected six strides. Big swing, nearly. It looked for an instant there that Eining lost his balance. But Eining doesn't lose his balance because he's Eining. There's five. And there's six. And on six strides that was. And he's home on a very quick run. Look at that. 69.16 seconds. That is, I believe, the fastest individual run we've seen. Peter Felixson and Catch Me Not S. That large striding grey by Cardento. And he can just cruise along here to the Bonsai Oxer. Inside turn here as well. And Valkenswaard United are about to set a very quick time. Each with a different approach. Eining with the high cruising speed. Fredriksson with leaving out strides and making inside turns when nobody else saw them. And here comes Peter Fredriksson with one stride less to the last, and it is 66.90. I think that's just a little bit faster. Well, that's 3 seconds faster than Marcus Eining. Oh, she has to wait and get deep. Just making it over the back rail. That tail swishing. The mare jumping with every fiber in her body. Fastest time trying to ride the clear round. Well weighted into the triple. Created room for that four-leg of Volage. And there's the clear for Jessica Springsteen and Volage du Valori. There's a time fault, 75.52 seconds. A single time fault. Two teams to go on four. And then another seven on clear. Hans-Dieter Dreher. You seldom see a time fault from him. Hansi on Berlinda by Berlin. Rides this very well. Attacks the plank. Challenges the mare. Holds for the five. And a seven, even at the ride for the seven at the time. He also has a time fault on that shorter striding mare, though he's a quick rider. The stride of the mare didn't allow him to get inside the time. And it's a time fault for Springsteen. And it's a time fault for Hans-Dieter. 6.06 is to beat. Oof, just over the back rail. This is real good. And now 5.3 seconds. Three teams to go. Three on clear. Leaders of Valkenswaard United with four faults. The time 1.36.06 could come into play. Here are the two-time league champions. London Knights. League champions of 2018 and 19. and they field Stallondo with Martin Fuchs and Olivier Philippards with Hurricane. Not too fast, but still with enough momentum for the first Oxer. And then slow over the two uprights. And the seven are nice and easy, and he's home on clear, and he is outside the time! Single time fault, the outside turn costs Stallondo and Martin Fuchs a clean sheet for London Knights. But maybe, just maybe, you can win this Global Champions League on a time fault. Margin to this man. Making the time allowed is going to be impossible. They are aiming for two time faults in the second round of the Global League in Valkenswaard. Maybe two time faults. No, they're off the podium. They're off the podium. They drop way down. It's going to be five and it's going to be six even for the team as London Knights make a big drop as well. Oh, even seven. And that is costly. Monaco Aces, Jean Sadran, Digisport Satisfaction. It is the first time that she has been really competitive. She's made a big development, huge development over the last months at five-star level. And the first time that she's put in such a position where not only she's tested, but also her performance has an influence on the team result. The team sits in a great situation, great position, on clear, with one team to go behind them. And a margin of four on Valkenswaard United. She was clear in round one. The young French is no longer clear. Monaco Aces on four. Fortunately, both Jean Sadran and Julia Payard sit on competitive and fast horses. And now it is all about the time. Seven strides. And she leaves them up. And she's just out of where she wanted to be. 71.34. 136.06 minus 71 seconds. That is the gap for the margin for Julien Epayard and Alibi de la Roque. That's 65 seconds. That's unbelievably fast. It hasn't been done so far. Dare to go forward into the triple. He speeds up as he jumps over Rulofsen. And there are the times, 136.06, and it is gone, it is all over. Monaco Aces will not be on the podium. They are on 8, and they stay on 8 and go into 6th position. This is Barclays. There's also Hermes Rein with Simon de Lestre. They've got the Scopy horse, and they've got the horse with all the experience and the speed. What's on their mind? Are they counting on four faults and not counting on the clear? That is the question. Glass can't make much speed in this first part. It has to be clear. Five! That helps. Ooh, and a stumbly landing for Bless, and he has to go wider. They made up some time with the turn, but they lost some time in the landing. And how does Jin deal with the situation? Keeps the same style and the jump. Inside or outside? Bless tries to steer inside, but Jin D not really cooperating. It is the smooth round, but so far it is a clear round for Bless and Jin and the Giants in the triple combination. Over the first, the second and the third fence. And here comes the finish on a very long six. And Bless is home in the time and on clear. And keeps the Giants at this point in the lead. But it was a real effort from the both of them that kept fighting for each other. And that gave the Giants now a 4-point margin on Valkenswaard United. Bless's time isn't fast enough to give Simon de Lestre margin on Valkenswaard United. It has to be clear. When it comes down to time, they will lose the battle with United and I think with New York Empire. Maybe they can win the battle with the Berlin Eagles. It just has to be a clear form. Hermes Ryan and Simon de Lestre. Ryan, you can really drive him deep to those Oxers. And still that mighty horse finds all the power to bounce off the ground. Long stride here. Extra stride in here on 7. And then canters on to that wide bonsai oxer. It has to be clear. Smoother inside turn. Rule of Sun out of the way. Last line. They won't make the time of United and Empire. It has to be clear. It has to be clear all the way. The only clean sheet of the afternoon for the victory. The Giants in Valkenswaard prevail. They win as the only clean team. The only clean sheet. Hamburg Giants with Bart Bles and Simon de Lestre win this competition in a tremendous fashion. They've struggled in the 2018 season and in 2019. But here, smiles all around. What a win for the Giants. High fives all around. A beautiful victory for this team. Here's the final results. Hamburg Giants win. Valkenswaard United come in second and New York Empire in third. Berlin Eagles just drop off the podium. 5 Cannes Stars, 6 London Knights. Bizarre scoring as well, 6 and 7 points. Then Monaco Aces that came in on double clear after round one. Paris Panthers are in there. Madrid in motion, disappointing. Also Saint-Tropez Pirates, we must say. Vikings on 16. Lions had also had a tough run. 3 clear rounds but still finish in 14th on 17 points. And then down there, Doha Falcons and Qashqai Charms, who already had a difficult first round.
Wow, Hamburg Giants, that was a spectacular performance. The only team to finish with 4 clear rounds. You must be really thrilled.
Yeah, we're really happy. The horses jumped today, fantastic. Good team also together and good clear in the first round. And then we make it ready in the second one. Really.
And you were leading from that first round as well, and Simon, you knew what you had to do and you really went for that time and it paid off.
Yeah, for sure. First round I tried to go not stupid fast but enough, then we can keep the lead. So it was good for us to know if we jump clear, we can win, that nobody has a double clear round. So that was sometimes good to go at the end of the course. That's okay, it's never done, and we go a little bit slow to make a good clear runs, and if we have one done we will go really behind, but okay, today was our day. My horse really, MS Ryan, produced an amazing job again, and I'm really happy to share with Bart. It's a good friend and I think we are together a strong team.
You certainly are a strong team. And Bart, what is it like to be able to compete back on Hamburg Giants again after such a break from competition?
As we have last year also good year, not so luck and everything, and now we is happy we have this show now and not so much shows this year. And when we can start like this in the really good 5-star show, the team and the horses jump amazing, and we're going to be really happy today for sure.
And it's amazing to be back here competing at Tops International Arena, isn't it? Simon, tell us a little bit about this venue. What makes it so special for you?
Okay, for sure it's amazing. 5-star. We are really happy to have a little for this year, which is really a difficult and strange year for all of us. So we are happy to be here and especially to win. That's a little bit the objective. But when you don't have so many 5-star like this year, you have to enjoy every victory.
Oh, well, congratulations again and enjoy your celebration.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for watching here. This Global Champions League presented by Stal. We will be back with another 5-star competition here at the Shop International Arena.
Don't hide your emotions.